What is up, guys? Today we're going to be going over a brand new product, which is a scratch resistant clear coat that comes in 4 different gloss levels. This stuff is going to be amazing for protecting your customs and acts as sort of a scratch resistant film that sits on top of your paint layer and preserves what's underneath. It's a urethane based clear coat, which means it's industrial quality for finishers and can be used on leather, vinyl, plastic, wood, and more. What really sets this apart from the previous finishers is that it's more scuff resistant and protective. You also get the choice of 4 different glosses, so let's try them out on some light and dark shoes so you can really see what each coat looks like. I'm going to be comparing 2 coats to each other, so the first thing I'm going to do is grab some painter's tape and split the shoe in half. And to even the playing field, both shoes have a few flat coats of paint on them so we can see what the gloss looks like over a painted surface. Alright, so the first 2 coats we're going to compare are satin and flat. The first thing you're going to want to do every single time is shake the bottle before use, as some components may naturally drift to the bottom of the bottle and need to be shaken beforehand. First up is our satin coating, and we're going to apply this using light and even coats with a paintbrush. Be sure not to add too much and spread out the coating evenly to avoid any brushstroke marks. When using a paintbrush, make sure the area is completely dry before application and use a heat gun to help with leveling. And then lastly, you can use a heat gun to dry the coating after it's been applied. Be sure not to hold the gun too close or in one area for too long to avoid any bubbling. For our flat coat on the other side, we're going to try out an airbrush for application. This will give you easy, quick, and clean results with no risk of brushstroke marks. I would recommend setting your pressure to spray sort of a mist to avoid adding too much coating to your project. So let's go ahead and pour some flat coat into our gun and apply about 2 to 3 even coats with drying times in between. So our goal is to add just enough to give it this wet look, and once it dries, it really morphs into its true sheen. Watch how quickly it goes from the wet look to completely flat once dried. Alright, now we can take the tape off and compare the 2 sheens. Satin has a very factory finish look with a very slight shine, while flat is absent of all gloss and sheen. Next up for comparison, we have high gloss versus matte, and I'm gonna apply them the same way I did previously. Apply 2 to 3 light and even coats with an airbrush and dry carefully with a heat gun. Let's take the tape off and compare the 2. Gloss has a really nice heavy shine, while matte has a more neutral look. And when we put all the coats next to each other, we can see that all 4 levels of sheens look amazing and really give you a variety of style for whatever look you're going for. Next, I'm going to do the exact same comparison method on some white slides so we can see what these shines look like on a lighter shoe. The main difference from 4 coat versus the previous acrylic finishers is that 4 coat is more of a protective coating, while the previous acrylic finishers are intended to just change the finish of the custom. Angelus paint is pretty strong in its own, but 4 coat will allow you to take the protection of your project to the next level. Now that we've covered how to apply and the different types of shines, let's apply a clear coat to a custom shoe. I went ahead and mixed up some different shades of pink for my absolute favorite pink tone colorway. So the first thing I'm going to do is deglaze our surface to prepare for our paint. And then from there, I'm going to apply 3 to 4 coats of my lightest colors to their designated panels on the shoe. Next, I'm going to go in with my darkest pink and color block in all the remaining panels. I'm penciling in some flames here, and then I'm going to go in and fill them in with an even darker shade of pink. And lastly, I'm just adding some shadows and highlights to the flames to give them some depth. All right, custom done. I'm gonna leave the other side blank so you can see what the clear coat looks like on a colorway with details and without. I'm also gonna compare two of my favorite sheens on the shoe, so let's tape a halfway mark again. For the flame side, I went with satin since it gives it a really nice factory finish look. For the blank side, I went with high gloss because it gives it this patent leather look, which goes really nicely with this light colorway. And then lastly, don't forget to clean up the holes on the toe box with a toothpick and acetone. In conclusion, these finishers are such a game changer for those who've been looking for a good way to protect their painted projects. With your choice of scratch-resistant coating, it's gonna make for some really great and well-protected customs.